This is the device with which we can calculate the atmospheric pressure. There is a trough. In the trough we have filled up mercury. Then we take a tube which is nearly 1 meter long. This 1 meter long tube, first we fill up mercury into it full. This we fill up mercury, and that mercury we fill up full. After that, filling the mercury, this is open end from where we have filled it up. We close it with the thumb and then make it upside down. Then, keeping it closed, we put it in the trough. Then, after putting it in the trough, we remove our thumb or the finger. When we remove it, what happens? We see the mercury which was filled up to the brim total, it starts falling down. And it starts falling down from here. It comes here, 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 and at a certain height it stops. After that it does not fall. When it was falling, this was rising a little, because it's a large surface. So this was falling, this was going up, and then it stopped at one place. After that it is not falling anymore, and the system now has come to equilibrium. So I will mark it here, this way. Okay, this height we measure with help of a scale. Let us say this height is h. Now, understand the action on this, why it is in equilibrium. There are air molecules in the atmosphere up to the top. There is earth below it, and the earth is pulling all the molecules, whether it is air or mercury or anything. So, here there is atmosphere. These are the molecules of the atmosphere, and these are being pulled down, and in the process of pulling down they are always pressing the surface at the bottom, and that is creating pressure on the bottom surface. So these molecules up to this much here, now they are in contact with mercury. So it is pressing this, it is pressing this, it is pressing this. The whole atmosphere, all the molecules are pressing this surface downward. If they are pressing this surface downward, what will happen to this mercury? It is pressed everywhere, but not at one place. Here is the hard glass. This hard glass here, there is a pressure on the hard glass, but that pressure cannot come inside. This I am pressing. This molecule is not being pressed because this is hard, right? So there is no pressure here, no pressure here, no pressure here, no pressure here, no pressure here. So all this liquid would like to enter it, because this is a high pressure and here there is no pressure. Okay, so this liquid has a tendency, this pressure, then mercury pressure, mercury pressure, mercury pressure, mercury pressure, mercury pressure, and here there is a certain pressure, P2. According to Pascal's law, P2 acts in this direction, in this direction, in this direction, here, in all the directions. So there is a pressure at these particles of the mercury in upward direction. How much? P2. And this P2 is created by this atmospheric pressure as well as this mercury pressure, P2. This is pushing the mercury upward. What's happening inside? Inside, air has no force because of the hard glass. But we have filled it with the mercury. And here, h height of the mercury column is standing here. how much is the force created by this mercury column? We know the force created by, the pressure created by SS dash. Where is the surface SS dash? I say it is here. SS dash. How much is the force created by this column? So the force created by this column, which has a height equal to h, is h rho g. This we have done in the previous lecture, that the pressure created by h height of column is equal to h rho g, where rho is the density of this liquid. Okay. This pressure has a particular direction. What is that direction? This. P1. Now, there was a force here. That force was due to atmosphere. Here at this place, that is atmosphere plus mercury. If we come up, then the mercury level become less. Here this much mercury, here only this much mercury, here there is no mercury. Then the pressure at this point from this direction is only equal to the pressure of the atmosphere. Yes. You can consider it this way, that if our tube is only up to this much, say. Now what's happening? This atmospheric pressure is pushing the mercury inside here, because the direction of pressure is in all the directions. And how much is the pressure? Right from top of the atmosphere. So this is atmospheric pressure, P0, which is pushing it in upward direction. And this column of mercury is putting the pressure downward due to mercury. So I write it P due to mercury. This is P due to atmosphere, and it is in equilibrium. Since the system is in equilibrium, pressure by atmosphere is P0, P by atmosphere. Then P0 is equal to h rho g. Why? Because there is equilibrium. It is neither coming down nor it is going up. If this pressure would have been less, this would have pushed it inside. If this pressure would have been more, as it was earlier, when it was here, the pressure was more, so it was pushing it down. But when it comes here, this pressure has decreased. Now it is equal to the pressure created by atmosphere. So it remains here. So atmospheric pressure is equal to h rho g, or h height of the mercury column. This we call h height of mercury column. This is a very standard method of measurement of atmospheric pressure or any pressure. When we do it on the surface of the earth at a standard place, that is near the sea, at the sea level, because sea level is something which is same all over the earth. The height of atmosphere from the sea level, whether that sea is in United States or that sea is in India, the level is same, so the height of atmosphere will also be same at both the places. So we measure standard pressure at sea level. So at sea level we have done it, and we found that this height at sea level, height of edge column, is 760 millimeter. That is 76 centimeter. Now, if we put it at 0.76 meter, how much is the rho density? The density of mercury is, I told you, it is 13,600 kg per meter cube. It is 13,600 kg per meter cube, and the value of G is 9.8. If you multiply all this, what we get is 101,000 Newton per meter square. This is how we could know that the one atmosphere can create this much of pressure. Or we can write it Pascal. So one atmosphere is equal to 1.01 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. That was done by this experiment. So certain more thing about this experiment. What is here? The answer is, earlier we filled it fully with mercury, and when we put it here, mercury has come down and there were no bubbles of air from here. So nothing has entered this place. If nothing has entered this place, then this place is perfect vacuum. And we call it Torricelli's vacuum. And this is an example of perfect vacuum. Absolutely no molecule of any gas or anything. Right. So now if I puncture it here, what will happen? This pressure will come here, press it, and it will flat down here. That is why we remember, whenever we create a vacuum, this will go up. So in a straw, we create a vacuum. And what will happen? We get a column here. That liquid comes into the straw because of this vacuum. So who is pushing it, pulling it upward? This vacuum is pulling it upward. That is what we say. Actually, vacuum is not pulling. It is atmosphere which is pressing it up. Anyway, in case of mercury, we are using water. Can we do this experiment? Yes, we can do. Because atmospheric pressure is same. But for water, this P will be equal to height of water into rho of water into G. This is again 9.8. Rho for water is 1000. And H, this we have to find. So how can we do it? This pressure is equal to this much. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, yes. This, now you have the H. H is equal to this much upon this much. Then, so this is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And this is equal to approximately 10 meter. So what will be the height of the water column? That will be 10 meter. 10 meter is so large. So we have to take which is more than 10 meter long. Then only we can measure atmospheric pressure with water. And that is not practical. So to reduce the height of column, we are using mercury because it's very heavy. This question is also asked, why we use mercury? So that the height of the column is limited. Otherwise, we can do this experiment with any liquid. And formula rho, we have to take for that liquid. Accordingly, height will be observed. We will multiply the two. This will come same. So this is experiments what we are doing with. This is measurement of pressure. Now the unit of pressure is bar in industry. So that is why this is known as barometer. And this is mercury barometer. So this is how we measure it. There is another instrument with which we measure the pressure difference, not the pressure, the pressure difference. And that instrument is known as manometer. Manometer. In manometer, we have a U tube like this. Here, at this point, we fit up the place at which the pressure is to be measured. Earlier, when we start experimenting with the manometer, then we are putting mercury in it. This. And the mercury will be at the same level. Now, we expose it to the chamber where we want to measure the pressure, P2. If this pressure is larger than the atmosphere pressure, before at this point, the pressure was same and the level of mercury was same. Now we put this pressure which is higher and it will press it. If this is pressing it, it will go down by this amount. This will rise up with the same height here. And this level and this level. These are the new levels and this gives us the pressure difference outside and inside. So we say inside the pressure is more compared to atmospheric pressure. So what does it give us? It gives us gauge pressure. This instrument is known as manometer. Okay. This gives us the difference of pressure inside and outside, inside a chamber and outside. Because what we are concerned, we know the atmospheric pressure. So what we are concerned is whether in this room the pressure is slightly larger or smaller than the atmosphere. We are concerned with the difference. And this tells us the difference. We don't have to measure the pressure here with help of a barometer, then take the barometer outside and take the pressure there and then minus the two. We don't have to do that. Simply fit this, you find the pressure difference, whether it is in excess or it is decreased. This is known as manometer. So these are few meters. In spite of that, we are using many different type of meters, and those are the one which are not using liquid are more popular. Because liquid means always spillage. And we have a different type of barometers which are without liquid and known as aneroid barometers. Aneroid. Without liquid. There are many type of aneroid barometers and mainly these are made with a tube in the form of a spring. When air enters it, the pressure enters it, this tube will get tensed. This. When it gets tensed, it spreads. When it spreads, this moves. And that gives us the measurement of pressure. Okay, but what we were supposed to study is the principle of barometer that is given by this. That is why it's important. This is made as standard one and all other type of meters are compared with this. Okay, so that's why it is so important. Now, in the next topic, we will see when the liquid flow, what happens. No, on the basis of Pascal law, there is a very famous device. And we see it every day. With help of that, we can create a very large force like a monster. I can lift a weight of 10 kg, not more than 10 kg. But if I use that device, I can lift a car of 1000 kg. Because of that device, and that device works on the principle of Pascal's law. That we will see in the next lecture. Thank you.